Good afternoon, guys. As I'm in the mood, I have decided, just because I'm bored as well and want something to do, I'm going to build a computer. I have actually forgotten to get one important piece of the puzzle. If I can find it, it's up here somewhere. Nope, that one won't work. That one won't work. No. Oh, what have I done with it? No. 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 Yes. So, I know there's people out there that like to play around with these old computers and may not know how to put them together, so this is a bit of a tutorial, I suppose. But like I said, I'm only doing this just out of boredom, mostly. And it's going to use this case up, because I was going to throw this case, but I actually found the hard drive caddy piece, so I've stuck that in there. So, should we go through a bit of a checklist? I'm not so sure now. I thought this might have been an Asus case, but it isn't. At least that's not an Asus sticker anyway. Anyway, got a CD drive, an Asus CD drive, and I think it is just a CD burner. I'm going to put in a card reader. I'm going to put in a floppy disk drive just because I can, and I've got a cupboard full, and it'll just fill up the gap there. I'm going to put in a 40GB Western Digital 400 hard drive. I've got the motherboard with the I.O. plate, complete with memory. It's only 512MB of RAM, but again, I'm not building this to be anything super duper. It's just got to work. I've also got necessary IDE ribbon cables there. And the only other thing I need to do is just get you up on the tripod. I'm just going to stick you down. The only other thing, what was it I needed to do? Pen and paper, that was it. Right. I'll just stand on everything on the floor because that's where I dropped it. I keep losing pens. I don't know how, but I keep losing pens. Right. Because I want to get the model number of the board before I actually fit it in. It's a Prescott. My pen might as well go in the bin. Bear with me a second. Okay, I've just found a pen, and I've just got the name and model of the motherboard down, because I'll need to find the drivers. Oh, and the other thing you will need is a Windows disk. So, what I need to do is put the pen out of the way, make a bit of room. I really don't like this tripod, but it's all I've got at the minute. Stand these, I don't know what actual standing down here, on the tub out of the way. Not the motherboard, because I'm going to start with the motherboard. This case has already got a power supply in it, so we don't have to worry about that. Now, never understood what these are actually for, but I just know you're supposed to put them on, so, and it makes it look better. But these just pop in the I.O. plate, in theory, should just pop in like that from the inside. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to cables out of the way so I don't put the motherboard on top of them. This is where you need to be an octopus and have like several pairs of hands. Let's just get that lined up. Like so. I'm just going to bring you over. So I'll show you what I've done. Motherboard just lays in like that. You just got to line these screw holes up. Like that. It's a two-handed job because you've got the spring of the IO plate there. Some of these cases will have little brass standoffs that screw in, but this one's got them all pre-moulded into the case. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to hopefully stand you there. Now, somewhere I've got a magnetised screwdriver. Not essential, but it does make life a heck of a lot easier. It really does. And of course, as I play with computers, I've got a cup of assorted screws. So, I've got to find ones that will fit on these mounts for the motherboards. I will just note before I go on that as this motherboard is using DDR memory, DDR SD memory, it's got a little keyway on the stick there, so these will only go in one way. You just got to line that keyway up with a little notch on the DIMM slot. If it's all lined up, they will go in nice and easily. If you've got to force it in hard, then chances are you've got it round the wrong way. Oh. This is where a magnetic screwdriver really does come in handy. Especially if you've got like your short stubby fingers like I've got. I do enjoy doing this. I don't know why, but I get a feeling of, you know, satisfaction when I've built one of these and it's working. Even if it's an old one, just like this. Just where I'm basically slapping things together in the vain hope that it works. On this motherboard, we've got 2, 4, 6 screws holding it on. Depending on the size of the motherboard, you might end up putting the wrong screw in. That one's too small. Not to worry. Hope I can get in here with a pair of pliers, grip it and pull it out. Without actually pulling anything else off the motherboard. Nope. I'll deal with that later. I'll get some pair of needle nose pliers and get in there to get that one. Because the magnetic screwdriver is not quite strong enough to pull it out. Of course, keep the magnetic screwdriver away from your hard drive if you are going to use one. Because you don't want to kill your hard drive. Unless you're using an SSD, I don't think it would harm an SSD. As there's no mechanical parts in it. But, yeah, I wouldn't. I've even got a case speaker on this one. Oh, well, that's actually handy, because there isn't a buzzer on the motherboard itself. It's all got to line up, so I'll do that first. So the motherboard is in. I've just got that one screw to do. It's holding in fine, but it's just going to be a... you know, it's just going to annoy me knowing that screw... Oh, that screw is there like that. Hang on, I'll just knock the latch for the ratchet mechanism. Right, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to get a bit of extra light on the subject. Hang on a minute. Is it plugged in? Can I plug it in? Bit of light from behind us. There we go. I knew these extra spotlights would come in handy. Right. Ooh. What shall I put in next? I can bring these cables down. What I'm going to do, I'm going to get the CD-ROM drive and put that in next. Now, with this case, let me pick you up again. It's got these, and all you do is line up your... I've got a feeling the floppy drive, either the floppy drive or the card reader goes in there, and you just line up the holes up in the side, because these have screw holes. I'll demonstrate with this drive, shall I? So that just goes in from the front, slides in, and it should all line up. And if it is, these will just push in and lock your drive in place. I don't know if there's any on the other side. No. We have got an option to put a screw in on the other side if you want. I've also got the option on this one to put in a second drive if I so wished. Now, I'm going to put the other ones in because they go in from the front as well. I'm going to put floppy disk in here. Not, don't need a floppy disk these days, but it's more like a placeholder just to fill the hole on this. And I'm going to put the card reader in. Getting there. Oops. Okay, so that wasn't a good idea. Ooh. Card reader's a little bit on the... side. I've got to go forwards a smidge. I don't know why it's that tight. Can't see to line up me holes. Oh heck no, it's gone too far in. I don't know what I'm going to do, I'm just going to screw that floppy disk drive in. And I use a slightly smaller screw than normal. I'm just going to whack in. One. I will put screws in the other side because otherwise it'll flex on that side of the machine when you're pushing on the drives and whatnot. Again, not really anything to worry about, but it'll just bother me. I'm just going to put another screw in here. There, so you can actually see what I'm doing. I have got another one of these card readers. I might be able to put in. Lined up. I wonder if I should turn those around and try the floppy disk drive up there. Shall we try that? Whoopsie. What just fell off? Oh, it's just come unclipped, that's all. There we go. Because it might be easier to line screw holes up with the card reader. Easier. Doesn't matter which way round these drives go. Poke that through there because that's got to go on the USB header. Oh, that works a darn sight better. Now, what I did earlier. The card reader just uses the same screws as a floppy disk drive. slightly smaller than ones that you would use on the hard drive or the power supply or anything like that. It's how easy it is to build. So easy. Right, I'm going to need a... just one screw on each side here. Just to make sure, you know, like I said, the drives don't flex when you press on them. One, and a couple of the smaller ones. One in the floppy disk. So to press on the front very slightly to line the screw hole up. And one more. It's got a different head on it, but it's the same size. That's all that matters. Oops. He says. Go from the back to line that one up. Right. Now. Hard drive caddy that I put in. I've got to put a couple of screws in there to hold that in place. One in there. I thought I'd lost this, but I actually found it in the box of heat sinks under my bed. Of all places. I thought I'd kept all those bits together because I've got several of these little sort of hard drive type boxes. Okay, put that at the top then. Right, so I'm now going to need four screws. One, two, three, four. Four of these type. One to go in there. And the only reason I like to put two screws in one side, I could put two screws in either side, but you don't really need to. If you just put, you could get away with just putting one, but it just stops the drive rocking. Whack one in this side just to help it stay stable. And I've actually noticed there's nowhere to put a fan on the front of this. And oh, I can. That's alright then. I didn't want to use one of my large fans on the back of this. It's just not needed for one. Right. I'm gonna get on my knees. Ooh. So can we see us better? You can see better than I can now. Four pin, two black, two yellow, your 12 volt cable goes up here. Just be aware, not all older motherboards have those. So if it's not there, then you just don't need to plug it in or worry about it. Simple. Right. Got the choice to have SATA on this as well. That's overkill really for what I want. This socket looks like a 20 pin and this power supply has got this option. So you've got standard 20 pin, or if you just slide that on there, it should clip, but the clips are broken. That'll give you a 24 pin. Which is what a lot of more modern motherboards seem to have. So we just plug in the 20 pin, we can leave that 4 pin off. And that can Alright. Stick that power cable up there. floppy drive power cable. That's that plug. And it just plugs on the back onto floppy disk drive. I'm going to plug in power. These plugs will only plug in one way, by the way, so all these plugs, even the ones on the motherboard, so you ain't got to worry about plugging them in the wrong way round. It's really not as hard as people think to assemble one of these. Audio, again, this one is actually labelled audio, and it will only go on one header on the motherboard. So, again, you ain't got to worry about going wrong there. And usually it's some motherboards have it labelled. This is actually labelled audio 1. Same with the USB headers and whatnot. They're all usually labelled. And we've got two USB headers on this one. Got a blue one down the bottom here. USB headers, I've actually noticed on a lot of motherboards, are actually blue. But like I said, they are also usually labelled. Right. And then you've got your header cables. These are all labelled. But they do vary in colour depending on case, but they are labelled anyway. And, actually, I can't see what I'm doing with that. I've put the USBs on. Let's take them off for a minute. Let's take the speaker off as well, out of the way. Again, your front panel cables, it's actually labelled panel. And it's usually the same layout for every motherboard, but I can't read it. I guess I can. I can see where it says to put the hard drive LED, so I know exactly where to put the power switch from there. It's usually stacked, so... Are we in view? You can't see a lot, can you? Can I zoom in? It's usually done, so your reset switch goes at the bottom. In this case, bottom right. Your power switch goes above the reset switch, directly above. Hard drive LED goes next to your reset switch, and in this case, power LED's got two connection options because depends on your board. But the power LED goes next to power switch. There we go. And if I've got the LED wires round the wrong way, they just won't light up, so I've just got to turn them round. We'll find out when we turn it on. Oh, where's the speaker wire? I better have a buzzer connected. Can't see stuff all. Right. So... The only other USB doofy we need is this one for the card reader, which for some reason they've put the header right behind the onboard USB ports. You're not in view, are you? So right there is where the other USB header is. Stupid bloody tripod. I really am going to try and find another one before this one ends up flying across the yard outside. Right. We are nearly there. The last cables to attach, I'm not going to worry about the back fan yet, it's just the ribbon cables. Now, with this one we've got, as usual, two IDE slots, and they are labelled IDE 1, IDE 2. You want to put your hard drive on IDE 1, and your CD drive on IDE2, and your floppy disk drive is actually down the bottom there somewhere. It's down here underneath this lot. And I do believe you can only put the cable on one way round. Right, so As this has actually got a lot of Asus parts in it, I'm using Asus cables. A bit long for what I need them, but that's fine. I wanted IDE2. Put that underneath all that power cable. Start to think I should have put these on first. And actually, before I start twisting those up, I could have really done with just a short one to go to the hard drive, but I couldn't find one in my box. Never mind. There we go. Oh, sorry, nudged you. Bring you back a bit and tilt you back. These will only go in the hard drives and whatnot one way as well, and the headers on the board. So you haven't got to worry about putting things in round the wrong way, because as I said, 99% will only plug in the one way round. And like I said, if you find yourself trying to force it in, then it's likely round the wrong way. It should just, plug in nice and smooth like that. Right, I'm just going to tuck that big old power cable up out of the way. Along with the IDE ribbon cable for the drive. Power cable for the CD drive. Some people do take care with cable management. I can't be asked. Right. Okay, I do believe the end with the twist in the floppy cable goes in the back of the floppy drive, if memory serves correctly. Yeah. There's no notches in it on that one. So, well, if it's round the wrong way, it just won't work. So, again, it's just a case of turning off and turning the cable around. But the one on the end of the for the board will only go in one way. Sometimes they have a little keyway on the end of the cable, and it just so happens that this cable doesn't. But I was using Asus cables for the CD drive and hard drive, so I thought I might as well use it for the floppy drive. Right, we are now actually ready to turn on. How many minutes have I got left? 4 minutes. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn off, I'm going to clear some room, I'm going to get that all connected up to the monitor and everything, and we'll run the install. Right. Is it going to work? I've got the power LED on. No, I haven't. I thought that was the power LED versus that. It's working! So we're detecting. Is it detected? I might have to just go into the system BIOS and make sure it's going to boot from CD first, otherwise it'll just keep trying to boot from the hard drive. So we press any key. Oh, maybe not. Yes, no, no, yes. Oh, it's actually done it straight from the disk. I didn't have to. Sweet. I've just noticed something, so I'm going to turn that off. That ain't going to help. There we go. Must make sure cables are plugged in, otherwise it ain't going to work. So we'll try again. The hard drive IDE cable wasn't pushed on correctly. Just let that boot. That's better. It should come up saying press any key to boot from CD, or is it? Oh, no, it didn't. Please tell me that's actually going to recognise that hard drive and I haven't got to go and find another one. Oh, that would tick me off. Turn these are handy. Handy extra lighting. Same spotlights as the ones up there. All LED. Right, so that's just going to load up the setup files. I was only going to put a 40 gigabyte drive on this because I didn't want to put anything that big on it. I'd have rather kept the 80 gigabytes for other machines, although while it's doing that I will go and get it because I don't suppose it really matters. It's 80 gigabyte IDE anyway, so... Nope, not that one. Did I put it in the Did I even put it in the cupboard? I can't remember. I've got a Maxtor drive here, but I don't think that one's a lot of cop either. I'll take that though. Oh, it must still be in the lounge then. It's not recognising the hard drive because it's only come up with the card reader slots, which is really weird because if I put an SD card in there I could probably install XP to that. Okay, I've got an 80 gigabyte there. Oh, I can see the drive I want, but I'm not going to install it into the machine yet. I'll show you what I'm going to do. Switch off. All I'm going to do is just unplug it from the back of the machine. Plug into this drive. So. Hopefully that'll stand there. Hang on a minute. Think. I won't recognise that one either because it's got a jumper on it setting it to slave. So we'll get rid of that. Right, try again. This is the annoying things about building computers. You'll have like little teething troubles like this. What's it going to do? Let's have a look here. Yeah, it's recognising the RAM, 512 megabytes, 256 in each DIMM slot. DDR333, 333 megahertz. Processor is a 2.4 gigahertz. It's not telling me what the hard drive is. That's what I was looking for in this. System time, system date is off. I might as well set that while I'm in here, mightn't I? Oh, bang on 17. Oh, sorry. Messed that one up, didn't I? What was it? Is it tab to go across? Yeah. It's just gone 5 o'clock, so set that to 17:01. Sunday the 9th? No. It's Oh, I'm going the wrong way. First, the 16th, I believe. That's definitely not 2006. There we go. So that's the system time and date done. IDE configuration. Ah. It's still not detecting my hard drive. We have an issue here somewhere. Right. Turn off again. I'm just going to see if I can get that to find a hard drive. Okay, so I found a hard drive that actually detects, but the boot order is in the wrong order, so we go down to boot device priority. First boot device CD-ROM, there we go, CD-DVD, that's all I need to do. F10, okay, and that should boot from CD. I still had those two. One of those, I think, is a 10 gigabyte drive, which ideally I was saving for my Windows 98 project. Yeah, this is now actually detecting everything it should detect. But it's not detecting that one, so that's a dud. It's not detecting these two, that's a dud. In fact, that one's making the click of death. So they're dead. And I walked away from that and forgot to hit the key to boot from CD. Because if you don't, it tries to boot from Windows. And there seems to be a Windows installed on that. No idea what. It doesn't want to boot on this, though. Right. Just do this bit and I can show you what we do through this part of the installation of XP. Still my favourite operating system, I think, that Windows has ever done. Hang on a minute. The ratchet mechanism. There we go. I zoomed out. I am zoomed all the way out. I can't go any further back because you'll drop off the edge. So I'm just going to sit here and just watch the screen so I can move you in a position. I haven't put the hard drive in properly yet because I just want to make sure the whole thing's going to work before I do that. But I'm going to go and find a fan to put in the back. A little 5-inch fan. My little, not 5-inch fan. Next one down. I've got to put in the back because this isn't going to need a large one. Setup is loading files. I'll hurry up and load the files. I don't got all day. I want to go have a nice soak and a bath. And I've got three hard drives to sit and take apart because I want the magnets. Because they're handy to have. Setup is starting Windows. No, it's not. Right. You could seriously go make a cup of tea when it's doing things like this. Searching for previous versions of Windows. Alright then. It's only a 40 gig hard drive. It doesn't matter. I'm going to put it on that partitional NTFS partition, so we hit enter. We'll give it a quick format. And we'll press F to format. I just think it just wipes everything that's on it, it doesn't do a proper format. Don't need to. That would just create a list of files to be copied, and it will copy those, and that's about it. the rest it will do itself, so I'm going to turn you off till we get to the next stage. Okay, this screen just asks for a name for your computer, so I'm just going to put in, Pony Organization Home will do. Everest will do. Password, if you want one, it's up to you. Time is all set correct, apart from location. There we go. This bit doesn't take long, so I'm actually going to leave it to run. Because then it'll come up with another screen. But then again, when it comes up with the next screen, you just press enter twice, if memory serves correct, and that is it. So I guess I'll turn you back on when the installation is done. Okay. The last part to do is the drivers. I'm just trying to get this into as good a position as I can. So I think it is installing the flash disk drive. Yeah, it is. I've put the ribbon cable for the floppy drive upside down, and how can I tell? Because the light is constantly on. So next time I shut down, I'll have to turn it over. Just let that install the flash drive, and then we can get to installing the drivers, because as you know, at the beginning, before I put this together, I noted down the motherboard make and model, and a quick Google comes up with ASRock, and you can get the drivers for this particular motherboard straight from the ASRock website, so that's pretty cool. All you really need is the LAN driver. Well, all that's available really that you need is the LAN driver if you want to use the Ethernet, audio, and VGA. I got a feeling this hard drive is so old, that's why it's taking forever. Oh good, it's ready to use. Oh hell. And we want that one. Might as well do the media first. Ooh, you can even burn it as an an ISO image, because it's got the auto-run INF on it. Well, what to? I could make CDs for this motherboard, but I don't see the point in doing that, really. Could. Maybe if I was going to sell the machine or something, I could include those CDs with it. May not need the LAN driver, I'll plug the... No, I don't want the demo program. Let's install the darn audio. I just want it to make noise. I am, just for shits and giggles. We'll see if the LAN works, shall we? This motherboard has actually got six. Well, there's no lights come on, so I presume I do need all the drivers and whatnot. Failing that, if that doesn't work, I've got LAN cards. I've got shed loads of LAN cards I can stick in here anyway. If I wanted to, just for shits and giggles, I could put a video card in there as well. Yes, I'll restart. Yay, we got sound. So I've obviously downloaded the right set of drivers for this, so one down, two to go. Take the CD out of the tray. Found another hard drive. Don't know if that one works or not, I can't remember. Do we get... Yes, we do. That beat me to it. I was then going to ask if we got the boot up tunes. My Windows 10 don't do that unless I restart the PC. If I restart the PC, I get the boot up tones. So it won't delete it, but that'll let me move it. That hard drive made a really weird noise. Hang on. I hate that start menu. Let's go into properties and just change that. Like that. My computer. I haven't got a scroll wheel on this mouse, so I've got to do it this way. I've gone past it, haven't I? Yep. There we go. Let's do VGA, shall we? We can get that done. So I can actually get this to go full screen. It shouldn't have to reboot. Okay, it does. I'm not going to restart yet. Okay. Got some weird Land Rover there. Let's get Firefox on it. I've just noticed my little land connection doohickey at the bottom there has done a vanishing act. How well can we multitask? Can I change the settings? Why is that only sitting that right in the middle? What happens if I do that? If I got to adjust... there we go! That is tiny though. Oh, that's a bit better. Can I just adjust that a couple more maybe? Another one? Nope. Go back. It's going to have to be that one. And I'll shut this down, turn that floppy cable up the other way. No, there's nothing to import. Do we have internet or is the LAN going to be an issue? Because if it's going to be an issue, I'm just going to go and grab a LAN card. No, it seems like it's working anyway. Possibly secure connection failed. Why? But yet this... Because it's on July for some reason and not January. I always find with XP it will have problems connecting to the internet. If, we are connected, so I haven't got to worry about the LAN. Okay. just go on our website just to prove that we are connected. Boink, there we go, Facebook login page. Right, close that. I'm just going to shut this off. My battery's getting low on the camera. It's done well, it's done a lot of recording. Pull out that. Put that back in. Oh yeah, and I've put a fan on the back there as well. Let's see if it boots. It's not seeking floppy drive though, it's floppy drive turned off. Not doing a hard drive sync. Floppy disk drive sync. It might be turned off in the system BIOS. I'll have to check that, but there we go. It's fully working. No antivirus, but there's not enough memory. Not enough memory on there for an antivirus. Well. Oh yeah, that's because I unplugged. I left the flash drive in when I turned it off. So it's just telling me the location does not exist anymore. Well, no, of course it's not, because I pulled it out. Pardon me. Yeah, AVG says you need a gigabyte of memory minimum. I could, because I've got a gigabyte I could stick on this, but it's really not worth it. Right. We are working then. I'm going to do that. Turn off. We're done. That's a computer built, as simple as that. So, I've actually got some editing to do. I'll stick all this lot together. My hard drive just made a horrible squeak. I don't think that hard drive's a very good one. I don't know what gives me that idea. I think the racket it's making is a good hint. Right. So, thank you for watching. I hope you liked this video and found it interesting. And if you did, hit the like button. Much appreciated. If you didn't, hit the dislike button, and subscribe if you want to. Much appreciated if you do, and thank you in advance, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.